You know, I'm calling a mulligan on that intro. Let's try this again. Sound is back. Should be back. We're going to try that intro again. There we go, that's better. Made it. Welcome everybody. Welcome to the lounge. We're trying this again. We're gonna get this dialed in. But first, as always, let's start with a little bit of flying, huh? Come fly with me, let's fly away. If you can use some exotic booze as a bar in far Bombay, come on and fly with me. Let's fly away. Come on and fly with me, let's float down to Peru. In that llama land, there's a one-man band, and he'll toot his little flute for you. Come on and fly with me, let's take off in the blue. Once I get you up there, where that air is rarefied, ooh, we gonna fly, star. Once I get you up there, I'll be holding you so near. You will hear a gang of angels cheer just because we're together. Weather-wise, it's such a cuckoo day. Why don't you say the word and we'll beat them birds down to Acapulco Bay. It is perfect for a flying honeymoon, they do say. So come on and fly with me. Let's fly away. Once I get you up there, where that air it is rarefied, baby, we gonna fly, starry-eyed. Once I get you up there, I'll be holding you so near. You are gonna hear a gang of angels cheer just because we're together. Oh, weather-wise, it's such a lovely day. Why don't you say the word and we'll beat them birds down to Acapulco Bay. Babe, it is perfect for a flying honeymoon, they do say. So come on and fly with me. Let's fly, pack up, let's fly away. There it is. Oh, we are at cruising out. Still a little turbulence on takeoff, but nothing that a skilled pilot and crew such as yourself can't handle. Welcome, Jess.
Hey.
Jess, tonight.
Am I unmuted?
You are unmuted.
All right.
She's got a little fuzzy condom on the top of her mic, so you can say those P's as much as you want.
Got it.
Try
it.
There it is. Look at that.
All those poofs.
All
those poops.
You talk about poop without
poop,
without puffing.
Poo-poo and pee-pee.
That's right. welcome, everybody. Hello, hello. Welcome. It's moving fast. Purple Music Box, Darth Joe, Kitschy Cooker, Darren Roberts, Clanky Robot, Jess Tasmic, Dr. Skipper Marley, Ahmed What the Fun Cast, Trader Bill. Hello, hello, everybody. Oh, so happy to see you all. Welcome. All you first-class flyers, those of you that join at the top of the show for Come Fly With Me, we're getting that intro dialed in. This is why I didn't want to do it for the first time on the anniversary show, because I knew it would be weeks of failure and ridicule before it finally happens.
I'm going to have to hit you with the stick.
That's right.
After this show.
The intro stick.
I have to beat you with the on your back. Whip ya.
You got to talk into the mic, baby.
Well, I am. Will you put it away the frick over there if I'm going to put it right in front of my face?
Do it. That's it's primed and ready to take whatever you can throw at it from the front of your face.
Ooh, you saying? I don't know. What are you implying?
Hold on one sec.
Trevor, if you put this too close to my mouth, I'm going to eat it.
There you go. There you go.
I
okay. See, Jess, it's difficult to get her dialed in at the top of the show because like a diva, like a celebrity, a celebutante, she only shows up minutes before the show and is completely disinterested until about 30 minutes in.
Yeah.
welcome. Cheers. Salute, everybody. Sipping on some fine Lagavulin 8 tonight, courtesy of Clanky Robot. Thank you very much.
It's a little birthday gift for her birthday.
That's right. A little exchange. thrilled to be crooning at her 40th birthday on Saturday. And that was a real treat.
Thanks for that pizza.
That's right. The delicious Focaccia Boy pizza. And also the tres leche.
Oh, that was a good cake.
Good God. Fantastic stuff. So salute. Cheers. We have quite the evening planned for you musically, and we never plan it, but I'm sure there'll be some interesting conversations had this evening as well. We never pre-plan anything on this show. It's just off to the races, and then whatever happens, happens, and we'll clean up the mess afterwards.
The only thing that's planned is the set.
That's right. That's right. And even then, sometimes it mixes around during the show.
You just throw that out the window and go with your heart.
The band hates me for it, but they can deal. What do we got for you? Let's start with another song real quick. Lovely little tune entitled, I Get a Kick Out of You. I get no kick from champagne. Mere alcohol, it don't woo me at all. So tell me, why should it be true that I get a kick out of you? Some like the Bob type refrain. I'm sure that if I heard even one riff, 'twould bore me terrifically too. Yet I get a kick out of you. I get that kick every time I see you standing there before me. Well, I get that kick, though it's clear to me you obviously you don't adore me. I get no kick in a plane. Flying too high with some gal in the sky is my idea of nothing to do. Yet I get a kick out of you. Get that kick every time I see you standing there before me. Well, I get that kick, though it's clear to me you obviously you don't adore me. I get no kick in a plane. Flying too high with some gal in the sky is my idea of nothing to do. Because I get a kick, babe, you give me that boost. Yes, I get a kick out of you. I get a kick out of you, and I do. Coming to you at the top of the lounge this fine Tuesday evening. Welcome back.
Thank you.
Jess is in the home stretch of, and if you want to throw it up, we'll chat about this. Coming up, starting March 10th.
March 10th.
That's right. Our very own Jessica Kelly, Jess Tasmick, the talented sculptor herself, will be featured in the Tied Up in Knots art show. Woo! At the factory store. So come on by and say, well, you got to get a little closer to the mic if you're going to talk.
I wasn't talking.
Oh, okay.
Trevor, you mind your mic, I mind mine.
That's fair.
Okay.
That's fair. Tied Up in Knots. You'll be presenting what? What are you going to have there?
The Calico Cavern Shadow Box.
Yeah.
If you've been following my Instagram, you've been seeing some of it. I stopped posting because I'm in a rugged place.
You're in that weird spot where...
it'll all come together, and when it does, it's like, woo! But right now, it's like, eh.
Yeah. We are going to be there on the Friday the 10th.
Yeah, you have to... It's inside the park, so you have to be there. Buy a ticket or be an annual pass member.
The factory store is inside the park.
That's what I've heard, yeah.
Hey, there we go. Fun
inside.
Stuff.
Inside.
I am going to eat some boysenberry-related foods.
Uh-huh.
I'm going to drink some boysenberry-related things.
Woo!
That's right. I'll be your embarrassing spouse.
No, I'll be my embarrassing me. You can join.
I always do.
You're always welcome to join.
That's right. Yeah. Tied Up in Knots. That's either their first art show, or it sounds like a bondage-themed event at Knott's Berry Farm, both of which I'm all for. There it goes. Bye-bye, Knott's.
Bye.
Bye. Very excited for you for this. This is going to be fun.
I'll be excited too.
One day?
Yeah, when it's done.
On the 10th?
No. I don't know when. I operate in a weird way.
Yes, you do. I mean, all artists have their thing. Oh, and by the way, check out, I believe, Kitschy Cooker. You have an article coming out about the Boysenberry Fest foods.
Ooh.
Looking forward to reading that because I need to know what to eat and what not to eat because there's only so much space in the stomach.
No, we're going to share. We're going to get all of it unless if it has pork.
That's right. Before it gets tied up in knots. All the art has to be made out of old ghost town wood or boysenberries. That's you actually are adhering to that.
Yeah, all dried boysenberries. I'm sculpting. I've made a clay out of boysenberries.
Clay out of boysenberries, and also you've taken bones from the ghost town.
I'm just incorporated the ghosts into it.
That's right.
I've put the souls, the ghost souls,
yes,
in the clay. And muddled that up with the boysenberries. And then, so the thing that if you buy it is hella haunted, 100% guaranteed, many ghosts.
Aggressively haunted is how it's marketed, yes.
Yeah.
It's in the kitchen right now, and you can't hear it because we have the door closed, but it's screaming.
It is.
In the kitchen.
Howling.
I'm going to taste everything on Thursday. My article will come out next week before the festival starts. Fantastic. Excited to be on the lookout for that. Everybody should be on the lookout for a Kitschy Cooker's fantastic, I'm sure, article about all the tasty foods. I'm going to get me a funnel cake.
Hell yeah, dude.
And what are, they had like a...
We're going to have a fat and sassy March 10th. I think that's my mom's birthday. Oh, well.
The art show is going to be tied up in knots, and so will my intestines by the end of the day. It's going to be fun.
It wouldn't be the first time. Won't be the last.
Or the last.
No.
Little food, baby. Can we boost Jess's volume? Yes, if Jess can get closer to the mic, we can.
I am up on it. I'm on it.
There we go.
I was literally right here, so I don't know.
Okay.
Is this better?
I cranked up Jess's volume a little bit. She's sitting a little closer. Thank you for that. I'm
a quarter of an inch away from the puffy part of this thing, that the puffy condom.
There we go. Oh, and the DCA has a food and wine fest coming up. Good Lord.
Oh, wow.
So many fests of food to eat. Looking forward to reading that as well.
I feel like the last one that we went to, it was not good. It was the holiday one, right?
Yeah, the holiday one, it for some reason. Good. Yeah, I feel like this year's one was all like just mac and cheese with everything different toppings.
Yeah, everything was mac and cheese. It felt like they were like, all right, guys, budget it down.
Right. We ordered way too much mac and cheese.
Where everything has to have the same thing that way, but just in different ways. That way we save money. We don't have to buy different things for each booth.
That tracks with Chapek, or did when he was there.
Yeah, that's what I feel like happened.
I would not be surprised. Wait, is that the new cool thing to do now? Steal bones from knots? I mean...
I don't know about cool.
I don't know about cool, but if you like it, you know. Knots, here's the deal. Knots charges you 25 cents to come in for the rest of your life. So I don't think they mind any sort of missing bones or animatronics.
You know, when we were walking through, I don't know what part, I feel like it's next to the ghost town, but then there's like the stores that kind of look like Wild West, but then they sell knives in them for some reason.
Yes.
When we were walking past that store the last time we were there, which was years ago, at the time, I assume that he wasn't a homeless man based on the fact that he was inside of a theme park, but finding out more about like their food programs and stuff, I do in fact think he was a homeless man. He demanded our attention. Mm-hmm. Hey, you guys, I need to ask you a question. Me and Trevor are like, yeah, what's up? And he's like, are you guys celebrities? And we're like, no. And he's like, nah, you're celebrities. And we're like, no. And then he's like, you know what? I can tell the future. And then he just walked away.
He did. He walked into the lake.
He walked through a wall.
I'll see you later. And he walked, and then that little swinging ride just obliterated him, and he flew off into the air. Goodbye, everyone. I wonder where he is now. Oh, he's in your thing.
Yeah, I muddled him up into clay.
That's right. What do we got next for you, cats? Speaking of getting obliterated by a ride, the good life. It's the good life. Full of fun seems to be the ideal. Yes, the good life lets you hide all the sadness you feel. You won't really fall in love, 'cause you can't take the chance. So be honest with yourself. Don't try to fake romance. It's the good life to be free and explore the unknown. Like the heartache when you learn you must face it alone. Please remember I still want you, and in case you wonder why, well, just wake up, kiss that good life goodbye. Please remember I still want you, and in case you wonder why, well, just wake up, kiss that good life goodbye. The good life coming your way here in the lounge. Oh my goodness, I love that song. It's a fun one. I mean, I might be doing that one coming up later this week. Oh, and by the way, Darth Joe, thank you so much for subscribing 13 months in a row. My goodness. Greatly appreciate all you hitting that resubscribe button every month. If you've linked your account with Prime, you have to hit the button every month. Otherwise, it just resets and we don't get the subscription. That sweet, sweet Twitch money.
We want it.
We wants it. We needs it. It helps us buy some booze and buy some fun stuff for the show throughout the year. So greatly appreciate you cats doing that. Oh, my goodness. Thank you so much for the applause. Clanky Robot, Kitschy Cooker, thank you for the chows. Tiki is my middle name. Thank you for those Pika chows. Mixmaster Pixel, welcome, welcome. Always a thrill getting to see the chat pack in person. And it was just really nice getting to sit at the same table as a Mixmaster Pixel at Clanky Robot's birthday. That was fun. And you trying to finagle your way into a trip to Yosemite?
Oh, I didn't try. I it's happening. It's happening. As long as it's happening, it's happening.
That's right. You know, we thought since the Lagavulin 8 is stronger. It when you open it up.
Ooh, it's peaty as heel.
I've never been to the coasts of Scotland, but I'm pretty sure I know how it smells now. And it was tasty. It was good in Rob Roy. We thought it might make us drink slower.
Mm. Well, I'm still drinking mine.
Yeah, so am I.
You're like us. No. Yeah. You. Mm-hmm. You. Yeah.
That's my Mitch McConnell impersonation. you just kind of.
You're like those Muppets.
So is he.
He is, but he's ugly. He looks like a turtle.
He's one of those Muppets that went evil.
Yeah. That money, it's corrupting.
That's right. I'm just, if any of you have any leads on how to sell out, let me know. I'm here. I'm ready to do it.
We're ready to turn into Mitch McConnell.
Just give me, maybe, is that the trade-off, though, is you have to have that balloon neck?
Yeah, 100%. I don't know 100%. If I want that, in those balloon hands.
Oh, yeah. He's got the Mr. Balloon Hands.
Mr. Balloon Hands. Sitting in the closet, Mr. Balloon Hands.
Fancy pants with your balloon hands. I don't want it then.
Dude, I don't know. If I was like just disgustingly rich and I didn't have to worry about a damn thing, I would be I would be disgusting.
Yeah.
Like I would be okay with looking like a Muppet turtle puffy hands.
Muppet turtle puffy hands?
Yeah.
That's a good nickname for him.
Yeah.
Mitch McConnell # Muppet turtle fluffy hands? Muppet turtle puffy hands.
Puffy hands.
That's right.
Yeah.
Not my chair. There we go, Ahmed. What the fun cast.
No problem.
recognizing that deep cut internet video. Oh, my goodness. By the way, a little, I'll probably take a clip of this and post it later, but a little shout out, a little toast to Trader Dan over at Strong Water. Tonight's his last night slinging the fire water over at Strong Water, and then he's off to wherever the wind takes him, I think.
Wandering into the sunset.
Yeah. Like the Incredible Hulk in the end credits. He's going to have a bindle full of rum fire, and he's going to hit the road and see what happens. So I'm very excited to see where he lands in his next chapter, but a real solid cat, great guy, and you know, wish him the best.
Oh, Dave's promoting the podcast, or at least a topic.
I've got plans for us to sell out coming soon to the podcast. Ooh, I can't wait to hear it. I am, and I think people maybe think I'm joking. I'm not. I want to be in the position to sell out hard. I want to be in the position to sell out so hard that there's underwear, and there's tampons.
Dude, you gotta write. You just gotta do a Gangnam Style. You just have to do one Gangnam Style, and you're set.
That's all I want.
Was that Korean?
Yeah, a little Oompa Gundam star.
Yeah.
Oompa Gangnam style.
Yeah. Yeah, you need to do one of those.
I said that in the whitest way possible. Oh, I don't understand the lyrics, so Gundam. Yeah, Trader Dan, definitely the end of an era. Era. Yeah.
We've been having trouble talking today, just in general. So it's probably carrying on into the show.
That's fair. I'm going to get a little...
booth.
A little boothy booth. I'm
trying to catch up, so that way you only have to do one.
We're back. We are back. Apologies for the disappearance. Just need to top off our beverages.
You should have a when you have your new set, you should have like a little shelf for your booze so you could pour in front of the folk.
That's a great idea. Yeah, stay tuned. By the way, end of March, our third anniversary show kicking off the fourth season of the show. We're going to have a brand new set. We're going to have some new fun stuff that you can trigger throughout the show. It's going to be fantastic. What do we got next for you, cats? Let's do a song and then I'll we'll chat some more. Mixmaster Pixel, why did the word twerk trigger the profanity filter? Why did it? That's weird.
Don't say it.
Whistle while you twerk. It's not a... Is twerking's not a bad thing.
No.
Twerking, is that the butt?
Yeah.
Is that the butt thing?
Come on, give us a twerk.
I can't do it.
Give us a twerk. You can't give us a twerk.
Yeah.
Give us a twerk. I don't care if you can't do it. Give it to us.
It's all on the knees, right?
Yeah. What, you mean, what was that?
That was me having a seizure in my knees as I twerked. This episode will never air.
It's good. It's good. You did a good job. I believe in you and your twerking
skills. Thank you very much.
I don't know why this. I didn't. I thought you had all of the things taken off. Like, I didn't think there was any sensors.
I am
the sensor, and I'm a bad one.
You are.
Apparently not anymore, because.
My gym trainer did say it's peach season. Oh, there you go. A little the peach. Also being the bottom. When did it move from apples to peaches? Something to ponder.
I always thought the peach was the vagina.
That's what I always thought, too.
And then I thought the eggplant was the diac.
It is, correct.
So peaches aren't the vagina?
I think a peach.
I mean, because this emoji peach looks like a butt.
Chime in the chat on this. Maybe we've gotten our fruits and vegetables misaligned with the body parts.
Yeah, because that doesn't, because the peach really does look like a butt.
All
like
I'm saying, it does.
The
but
apple does not.
The apple bottom jeans.
Apple bottom jeans. Wait, apple bottom jeans.
I thought the peach is the booty. Apparently we were incorrect.
I mean, I'm just misinformed. Nothing new.
We missed that. Our schools failed us, is basically the long and short of it. They never taught us what emojis. I wonder if they teach that now. What emojis align to what?
Taco is the V now? Okay. Oh. Well, that makes sense, too.
That does.
I also have heard it be called a pastrami sandwich before.
That's horrific.
Yeah, that's pretty gnarly, dude.
There's two slangs that I've heard that are horrific. That's being one of them. And the old axe wound was the other one that I heard that was just horrific.
Have we gone off the rails?
We've gone off the rails.
Oh, choo-choo.
34 minutes. mark the time. The old catcher's mitt. Oh, God. We definitely have gone off the rails.
The old catcher's mitt. No. What, like just leathery?
I'm not diving.
Stitched up and leathery?
I am not going to dive in and figure out why.
The ninja shoe? Why?
The ninja shoe. Oh, because of the knuckle.
It has a knuckle. The ninja shoes have knuckles. Are you thinking about
like the toe? Like the toe on the ninja shoe.
I don't know what a ninja shoe looks like, apparently.
I don't know.
It looks like my vagina.
It does.
Axe wound is also awful.
These are all awful. Jesus. I'm singing a song. Oh, this is great. This is a. You couldn't have planned this better.
What is it?
This next song, How Insensitive.
Is that what the song's called?
Yeah. I must have seemed when she told me she loved me. How unmoved and cold I must have seemed when she told me so sincerely. Why she must have asked, did I just turn and stare in icy silence? What was I to say? What can one say when a love affair is over? Now she's gone away, and I'm alone with the I see it still, all her heartbreak in that last look. Ah, por que você foi fraco assim, assim tal desamado? I to say, what can one say when a love affair is over? Ah, a lovely, hauntingly beautiful, about as haunting as your shadow box. Antonio Carlos Jobim, How Insensitive. Let me throw on the old Rubens and dive into the chat pack. We're off to a great start. Great work, correct? Yeah. We need more empowering language for lady bits. Agreed. Yeah, they're all kind of awful. Oh, I'm sorry.
Oh, you motherfucker.
I know.
I said there is some, like, flower kitty.
You said my princess?
Yeah, one of my friends calls her vagine her princess.
That's good. That's a nice princess. One.
Yeah, I call it nothing. It is just an organ in which exists upon my body.
You call it the void.
No, you call it the void. It's the void.
No, I think that's agreeable. Yeah. Because, I mean, That's doing all the heavy lifting. That's the more intricate thing going on.
I feel like your butthole's doing most of the heavy lifting.
My butthole has given up.
I mean, on like a day-to-day basis,
it's like,
the fucking butthole is where is doing all the work.
40 years of magic. It'd be 40 years of adventure.
No, it's 40 years of abuse. Yeah. Like, didn't you just eat like pizza from Costco? No, hot dogs from Costco for like years?
I did. Fun fact. Fun story. Story time. Back in the day when I was very, very broke all the time. There we go. There's story time music. And let me know if any of you did this as well. Back when I was so broke that I had less than $100 to eat off of a week, I would primarily eat in the food court at IKEA, which mainly consisted of hot dogs and cinnamon rolls.
That means you had to drive your ass down there, though, so you're not very fiscally responsible.
No. There was no fiscal responsibility in this. Most of my money was spent in gas getting up to Disneyland to work and hang out with my friends. So most of my time was spent in the IKEA food court, Wiener Schnitzel. And then later on I found out that the hospitals apparently have good food options
cheap
for cheap.
Food. Dude, I realized that too late in the game. Maybe I had forgotten because I feel like I've been to the hospital enough. But was when you had to get your surgery and I was just like putzing around in the hospital. And then I slept in the car most of the time, but then I got hungry and I was like, fuck, I guess I got to spend too much money at the hospital. And it was like so cheap.
It's dirt cheap.
It wasn't good, but it was dirt cheap.
Yeah. Swedish meatballs. That's right. If I wanted to feel fancy, like a fancy boy, I'd go upstairs to the nicer food court.
Wait, what?
There's the one below when you exit, and they're like, "You want a fucking hot dog?"
Oh yeah, that place.
And if you go upstairs, it's like very nice. There's salads. There's Swedish meatballs. There's lingonberry soda. Good stuff. Yeah.
I like the idea of lingonberry soda because I don't. It's not something that's like a thing that happens that often, but I do not like it. It tastes like crap. But yeah. I love the idea of it.
Did you ever mix it with
Trevor, I went there with you, so probably not. Unless you told me to.
Probably did.
You probably did. Oh,
that's
then
right.
Yes, I probably did.
Lingonberry mixer on tap. That's right.
Probably hated it still, though.
Did you hear Costco added a roast beef sandwich for $9?
That's too much.
That's a game show, right? Too much.
That's too much. I don't know. How dare Costco add anything over $5?
By the way,
it's a whole pizza.
I apologize. I didn't shout it out. Thank you, Johnny Thunders. Welcome. Thank you for the love up there. I don't know that anybody going to. I mean, I'm sure it's good. That was another one. Was Costco's food court?
That's what I was talking about.
Yeah.
You moved over to.
Although I wouldn't do the. I did the Caesar bake once. The Caesar chicken bake thing once, and I died.
Sick.
They found me dead on the bathroom floor.
That was one of my latchkey kid meals. We'd go to Costco. I would have the bakes. I would have Hot Pockets, you know, because we did Costco runs. And the bakes was one I insisted upon because if I have to make myself dinner, I want to make myself a bake.
That's right.
Yeah.
This is making me want Costco pizza. That was another big one. It's amazing listening to this that A, I have a functioning intestinal system, and B,
no.
I'm not 3,000 pounds.
They're going to raise the price of the hot dog?
I have not heard this. I read an article once where it said the Costco CEO was told that if you ever raise the price of the hot dog, I will murder you by the owner of Costco.
Did he die?
He may have.
Because, like, it's a freaking hot dog. Just let us pay $1.50 for it with your soda drink. You're still making money.
That's right. I'll tell you what. I'll do you one better. Bring back that Polish sausage. None of this hot dog tomfoolery. That Polish sausage was where it was at, see?
Yeah. Mixmaster Pixel, Latchkey Life was real. Yes, it was. But my favorite thing when I was too young and my parents thought that I shouldn't stay home by myself yet, they found a random neighbor that lived near me actually across the street. She had just moved in. They definitely did not know her, and just had her take care of me. So that happened, and then I became a latchkey kid.
There you go.
And I like looked back, and I freaking hated being there because that house was disgusting, and she was like a seamstress, and like sometimes it like I sew, so I know the struggle. But needles fall all over the place, but they had carpet, so I have this distinct memory of like sitting Indian style on their carpet and just having a needle that was pointing up go straight into my calf all the way and having to like get it out. So yeah, that's where I was before I became a latchkey kid.
Not allowed to use appliances, no hot food. That's a
wait, what?
That's a tough rule for a latchkey kid. Purple music box.
Wait, so you were a latchkey kid and they wouldn't let you use appliances? Rude.
I mean, it's fair. I mean, it's not fair, but I did light something on fire in the microwave accidentally once.
What'd you do? Story time.
Apparently, you're not supposed to put stuff in plastic wrappers in the microwave. Yeah? It melts and lights on fire.
Don't put a pop tire in the microwave either, because that will also light on fire.
Metal lights on fire.
It'll mix lightning. Oh my god! I remember one time. I attempted to boil eggs, and I didn't boil them all the way. So I was like, "Oh, like this one's a little runny. But if I pop that BZ in the microwave, it'll finish, and then I can eat it." Great idea, Jess. So I pop it in the microwave for like a couple seconds, or I don't even know how long as a kid. Start cracking it open, and I can hear like a sound that is the sound of steam, like. And I'm like, what is that? So I put that
It's just the sound an egg makes.
So I put it to my ear.
Oh, no.
And then it exploded all over my face. All over my face and all over the blinds. And I was more concerned about the blinds than my face.
Well, on that note, we're going to do a lovely little tune that we haven't done in a hot minute. Feel free to chime in with your latchkey kid stories. We're going to do a fun little song from the Cars entitled Just What I Needed. I don't mind you coming here and wasting all my time. 'Cause when you're standing oh so near, babe, I kind of lose my mind, yeah. It ain't the perfume that you wear, it's not the ribbons in your hair. I don't mind you coming here and wasting all my time. Mind you hanging out and talking in your sleep.
Sleepless, baby.
It doesn't matter where you've been, as long as it was deep, yeah. You always knew to wear it well, and you look so fancy I can tell. I don't mind you coming here and talking in your sleep. I guess you're just what I needed. Oh, I needed someone to feed. I guess you're just what I needed. I needed someone to bleed. I don't mind you coming here and wasting all my time. 'Cause when you're standing oh so near, I kinda lose my mind, yeah. It ain't the perfume that you wear, it ain't the ribbons in your hair. I don't mind you coming here and wasting all my time. I guess you're just what I needed. Oh, I needed someone to bleed. I guess you're just what I needed.
I needed someone to be. You're just what I needed. Oh, you're just what I needed, yeah. Just what I needed,
It's a lot. I agree with that. I agree with that assessment, Mixmaster Pixel. That's why we only do this song once every probably 8 months.
You probably were like, oh, we haven't done this song in a long time, and then you forgot.
Oh, absolutely. Right when we got into it, I'm like, okay.
Oh, shit.
I understand why this is high up on the list of things we haven't done in a minute.
You should just take it off of it.
I'm gonna. There's a couple that have dropped off over the years.
Yeah.
That's gonna be one of them.
Yeah.
Well, thank you, Mixmaster Pixel. Thank you, Clanky Robot. Do you ever do any punk songs, Johnny Thunders? I don't know. I don't know if I've done Metallica has popped up on the show. From time to time.
Which one's that?
Metallica.
That.
Nothing Else Matters.
Oh, then nothing.
Never
matters.
Know which way to go. So that pops up.
There was Black Hole Sun.
I do Black Hole Sun occasionally. Yeah. I almost did that. I almost did Black Hole Sun tonight.
Black Hole Sun. Where you going?
See? Why do you even need me here? And it depends on what your definition of punk is, but we've done some Green Day occasionally.
I think that's technically punk before... Did he ever move? Because I remember he was like...
He wanted to move.
He was like, I'm going to move. They don't allow abortions anymore. I'm moving to England. Like, that's going to help anybody.
And you're correct, Dr. Skipper. Dr. Skipper has been barking up that tree for years. And no, I know the answer to the next question is no, I will not be doing Anti-Flag. if somebody can find a Sex Pistols song, we'll throw it up as the sellout song, and I'll happily figure that out. That's what I figure. I figure a true punk aficionados probably don't traffic in Green Day as pure punk.
Mm-mm, I don't think so. I saw them in concert like once, and then that's how I discovered Flogging Molly.
Oh, Flogging Molly. Yeah. Was that a St. Patrick's Day concert?
I don't know. I just saw they were headlining for Green Day.
Ah, there you
and
go.
And I was like really into it. I thought it was really fun.
Green Day is a fun band to watch in concert. It's been a hot minute.
Yeah, they were fun too.
They put on a good show.
Mm-hmm.
Big Sandy, that's right. I'll be posting that Big Sandy song from Mardi Gras this week. So check that out on the Instagrams and the YouTubes. I did the meme last night.
What'd you? Oh yeah.
The Nick Cage meme that's so popular with the kids now, and it was fun. Instagram was great. TikTok was great. YouTube, not so much. A plague on both your houses, YouTube. Some mean little trolls on YouTube.
Yeah, Trevor said that immediately. I was like, were they making fun of me? No. Were they making fun of me?
I'm like, what is the purpose of this? To just take the piss out of somebody. So I deleted them.
Good. You destroyed them from the, you that's evaporated right. them from your lives.
I Thanos'd them like that.
Yeah. And now we know why. Thanos just got picked on a lot.
He probably did. He probably had he posted one too many YouTube videos and everybody picked on him with his little ball sack chin. And
he
said,
did not like that.
I'm going to take over the universe.
Get
I'm
rid of half of these motherfuckers.
Yeah, that's right.
Yeah. You know what? I don't blame him. I don't blame him.
Right?
Depending on my course of life, I might have been a Thanos too. You know? Who knows? We could have all been Thanoses.
I feel like most of us, on a certain level, slightly relate to Thanos' game plan. Off the rails.
We have gone off the rails.
That's right.
That we've basically both admitted that we would be fine with evaporating half of the galaxy.
That's true. Oh my goodness! All right, let's do another song. We just did just what I needed. Let's do a lovely little tune entitled "Just One of Those Things." It's another one that we haven't done in a hot minute, and no Mixmaster Pixel. This one does not feature horny anime girls in the backup vocals. Boop. I get one a show, and I'm taking it right now. It was just one of those things, just one of those crazy flings, one of them bells that now and then rings, just one of those things. It was just one of them nights, just one of them fabulous flights, trip to the moon on gossamer wings. It was just one of those things. If we thought a bit about the end of it, when we'd started painting that town, we'd have been aware that our love affair was too hot not to cool down. So goodbye, bye, baby, now and then. Well, here's hoping we'd meet now and then. It was great fun, but it was just one of those things. It was just one of them nights. It was just one of those fabulous flights. That trip to the moon on gossamer wings. It was just one of those things. If we thought a bit about the end of it, when we started painting that town, we have been aware that this love affair was too hot not to cool down. So goodbye, bye, bye, baby, dear and amen. Well, here's hoping that we meet now and then. It was great fun, but it was just one of those things. Just one of those things. Just one of them crazy flings. coming your way by way of Francis Albert Sinatra here on a Tuesday night in the lounge.
Love it.
Love it.
Love it.
You know what I'd love?
Love it.
A little bit more Lagavulin 8, please.
I agree,
and thank
but
you.
I need to get ice, dude.
Oh, we do need ice. Jess will be back. Do you mind throwing up the 616 button? I'll chat about that while you're doing your thing. Thank you, Amanda. What the Funcast? By the way, coming up this Sunday, if you are in the Orange County area, come on out to Club 616 in Santa Ana, Sunday, March 5th at 6 p.m. Have a fantastic night of entertainment and music planned for you. Come on out. It's a fantastic new 60s slash 70s kind of vibe of a lounge in downtown Santa Ana. They have a fantastic cocktail program spearheaded from the amazing Trader Sam's legendary bartender, Skipper Ash. How can you go wrong? And if you're going to Adventureland Day, I saw the schedule. Plenty of time to get your adventuring in and come on down to Santa Ana for a lovely, lovely drink at Club 616 with some crooning. What better way to end Adventureland Day, I would say, than come on down there rather than sit and wait looking at your phone desperately to be let into Trader Sam's. It's going to be like a 10-hour wait probably that day. I've heard rumors that it's going to be a 35-hour wait at Trader Sam's, and they are going to take a gallon of your blood before they let you into the bar. I'm just a vessel. I'm just relaying what I heard. I'm not starting vicious rumors. I'm starting vicious rumors. Come on out to Club 616 Sunday at 6 p.m. And join me and Jess Tasmic and a bunch of fun cats for a lovely evening of music and tomfoolery. I'm sure it's going to be a great night. Dr. Skipper Marley's going to be there. By the way, for those of you that follow the jungle, good God, I don't understand how this is. I don't know if nobody listens to podcasts, so the bar is low. But I was just recently informed by one of the websites that does our thing. Oh, there she is. There she is. Yeah, look at that.
That like, you looked the worst thing.
You looked like, you looked like the McGonagall from... from Harry Potter.
Harry Potter.
Yeah, there you go. Jess Tasmic, everybody.
McGonagall. Wait, no. I like her.
Yeah, it's not a bad thing. There you go.
I thought I looked like the dude with the eye that just wobbles around.
Oh, yeah. Mad-Eye Mooney.
I thought that's what I look like.
Yeah.
So thank you for the compliment,
You're
Trevor.
Welcome. I'm full of them. Yeah, come on out. It's going to be a fun night. Going to do another song in just a moment. And then we have one more thing to kind of to chat about coming up.
I might have given us a lot. I don't know.
Oh, no.
I don't know. Is there a lot?
I don't know. Maybe. We'll find out. I'll see you in the morning.
Oof. Don't let this be another...
This is why I like to use the shot glass.
I want to say interception, but that's wrong. Yeah. What's the word of the Capitol being stolen by a bunch of hillbillies?
Insurrection?
Don't let this be another insurrection.
Nothing's ever going to get to that point ever again, at least on air.
Yeah. For all the people that don't know, the insurrection hit Trevor really hard, and obviously because that was a terrible experience that we were all living through. And he had this is during lockdown, right?
Pretty much. January 6th on lockdown, yeah.
2021 or 2020?
I don't remember.
Anyway, and he had a live with Dave Marley, and he just proceeded to drink like one of those giant bottles of Jack Daniels. I think we had a quarter left of it, and he drank it all, but the really, really, really big ones.
We had a full one, and I drank a quarter of it
an
hour.
Yeah, in like 1 hour. So by the time I got out there, he was blitzed. And me not having any sort of sensor, which Dave did, because Dave kept on trying to end it, I was egging it on, which didn't help.
Dave still had his spidey senses about him. He's like, shut it down.
Yeah, like, he's like, we should go, we should go. And I was like, no, this is great.
2021, look at that. They all meld together.
Yeah.
Yeah, fun night, but we're never getting there again. But again, this is why we use shot glasses usually. Because Jess just goes like, I guess this is fine.
Well, usually I am, but I don't have practice anymore. I'm not the one that pours anymore.
That's right.
I don't know why. This is too much.
Absolutely.
This is way too much. I could pour it back in the bottle.
No. It's too late. We'll just save it. We'll just make it work through the rest of the show and into Mario Kart.
Hell yeah.
Spidey Sense, a.k.a. Deb. That's correct.
She's like, Trevor is blinking one eyelid at a time. End it.
That's when you know.
My favorite was when you didn't know you couldn't put in your own password to your computer.
That was fun.
That should have been the indication to make it end. But
to be fair, though, I never know the own password to my own computer.
Okay. Well, that's good because you just kept on trying. You were about to cancel it, you know, like when you put it in too many times, it won't let you do it anymore. It
locks me out.
Yeah. And that wasn't a good enough sign for me to be like, maybe I should shut it down. Yeah. I was like, let's do this. Let's see where this goes.
Chaos monster.
I found out where it went.
That's right. Let's do a lovely little, with that beautiful lead in, let's do a lovely romantic tune. One of my favorites, actually. A beautiful song entitled, What Are You Doing the Rest of Your Life? South and east and west of your life. I have only one request of your life, is that you spend it with me. All the seasons and the times of your day, all the nickels and the dimes of your day, let the reasons and the rhymes of your days all begin and end with me. 'Cause I want to see your face in every kind. Stand before the candles on a cake. Oh, let me be the one to hear the silent wish you make. Those tomorrows waiting deep in your eyes, in a world I'll awaken what's asleep in your eyes, but it may take a kiss or two for all of my life. Summer, winter, spring, and fall of my life. How you spent your life with me. It's a beautiful, beautiful tune. What are you doing the rest of your life?
It's way too big of a question.
Correct. Let me throw on the old Rubens. Dive into the old chat pack. You're less of a chaos monster in your Middle Ages. Incorrect. Trader Bill, love this. Fantastic. Thank you, Trader Bill. Mixmaster Pixel, this is a classy, gentle banger.
I don't like those words.
You don't like those words? Thank you, Kitschy Cooker. Greatly appreciate it. I mean, it's a gentle banger. You need those. You need those gentle bangers. They can't all be bangers. It has to have different speeds. Thank you, Clanky Robot. Thank you, Trader Bill. Glad you cats dug those.
Got itchy eyeballs.
You're about to be muted.
My eyeballs are so itchy. Like, how do they hurt so bad?
I don't know. Your eyeballs itch every day.
No, see, you do that. I say something maybe twice in my life, and you turn it into it happens every day.
Yeah. What are you doing the rest of your life? A fantastic, fantastic tune. Gosh.
Itching my eyeballs.
That's what you're doing the rest of your life?
Yeah.
What are you doing summer, winter, spring, and fall of your life?
Itching my eyeballs. There you go. Definitely allergies, 100%. What?
I watched a video about Andy Richter was on a talk show, mm-hmm. and somebody asked him what makes a good co-host, a good sidekick on a talk show, mm-hmm. and all I thought of at that moment was that video. I'm like, there's Andy Richter who's like helping and like blah 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 and bringing the A game, and then you're just like, my eyeballs are itchy.
Yeah, dude, they burn.
And I love it. I love it. It's its own. It's its own flavor. It's a. You're the gentle banger. Of
I'm
the
not
co-host.
Don't call me that.
That's right.
Don't call me that. I don't like that.
Thank you for the crooked lamp emote. You ever want to pop your eyeballs out and wash them in the same way you take a ball out of an old computer mouse and clean it?
Yes. That sounds disturbing, but yes.
I mean, yeah, I guess that would be kind of nice.
I like just because it gets so dry in there.
Do you ever wonder? And
it's like there's like your eye sockets are brittle Brillo pads.
We're in the weeds now. We're off the green, and we're definitely in the weeds. We're in the rough. We're off the rails.
I can't see if it's up.
Well, you can look at it. You can turn around.
Look, because there's the thing in the way.
There it is.
Oh, I put it away too soon.
Did you ever wonder, like if something flies in your eye, like if a bug flies in your eye or something flies in your eye, do you wonder, is the back of your eye just like a Sarlacc pit at a certain point?
I mean, I've heard.
Or does it absorb?
I've heard that. What are the people, the mortuary, what are those people called?
Morticians.
Morticians know if you're a hairstylist based on how much hair you have behind your eye socket.
Oh my gosh, that's the worst thing I've ever heard.
Behind your eyes? Yeah, so if that's true, then yeah, kind of. Either it comes out or it just goes in.
Is three the off-the-rails record? Correct, it is, so far. Since we've been doing the off-the-rails image, this is the record.
Yeah, but who really knows, you know, before we were keeping count.
That's true. What are you doing the rest of your life? You know, I kind of want to do, there's a song I wanted to do. This has turned into horrific.
I think you should do it.
Well, yeah.
Whatever it is you want to do, you should do it.
Okay, I need to set something up.
Oh, he has to set something up.
To get the band ready for this. This is a song I was thinking of doing tonight, but as pretty as... What are you doing the rest of your life was, it made me think, I kind of want to sing this song. What are we at?
The last comment.
Oh, yeah, the body horror, yeah.
That's the chaos monster. It's not me. It's a...
We're going to sing our way out of this horrific thing right here. See? We're going to sing our way into something nicer.
Look, we earned a sub, though.
There we go. Ahmed, what the Funcast. Thank you very much. Going to do a lovely, lovely tune from the Rodgers Hammerstein play, The King and I.
I love this song.
It's one of my favorite songs in the world. I have not done this song in probably like 6 months.
Why?
Because for a minute, I was so in love with the song. This song is like Come Rain or Come Shine is currently, where I love the song so much. I want to do it every couple of weeks. And so it needed to take a little break.
You should do it as much as you want. Yeah. Burn everybody out on it. Burn them out. It's all about you, baby. It's your show. Am I being a better co-host?
Yes.
Do it.
All right. We're doing a lovely little tune from The King and I entitled I Have Dreamed. I have dreamed that your arms are lovely, and I have dreamed what a joy you'll be. I have dreamed every word you whisper when you're close. You are close to me. How you look in the glow of evening. I have dreamed and enjoyed the view. In these dreams I've loved you so that by now I think I know what it's like to be loved by you. I will love being loved by you. In these dreams I've loved you so. To be loved by you, I will love being loved by you. That is a pretty one. I Have Dreamed from The King and I by way of Frank Sinatra's little arrangement of it. Love that tune. Oh, my goodness. One of my favorites. I'm probably going to do that at 616.
You should. You have to do Sinner because they play it there and everybody will recognize it.
Thank you, Clanky Robot. Thank you, Mixmaster Pixel. Speaking of upcoming events, if you don't mind hitting that button, we have one coming up on the show. No, not 616. Oh. We have one coming up on the show in the next couple of weeks.
No?
Yeah. Whatever you want. Oh, there it is. There it is.
I don't know because it's like a new
Disney night coming in March 14th. Can't wait for this show. I'll probably put a question in my story after this show to see recommendations for Disney songs for Disney night. Oh my goodness. I was just thrilled to bring these cats back. I think they're going to have to come back routinely. This one's fine, but this one right here, big fan of this belly.
You've unmuted me, right?
Yes. You're unmuted now.
Thank you.
Disney night, March 14th. I'll be putting a sticker on the story at the end of the show. Please send in your suggestions, and we're going to have a magical evening of Disney bangers.
So they suggestions for songs?
Yes. On Pi Day, that's right. So we're going to eat pie and listen to Disney music that day. Going to be fun stuff.
And not piss anybody off eating pie.
What?
And not pissing off anybody eating pie.
We're going to do a lovely little tune about a witch. Let's do some witchy witchcraft. Took me a minute to see the set list. Ba-ba-ba. Been a hot minute since we've done this one. Those fingers in my head that sly come hither stare, strips this conscience bare, it's witchcraft. And I got no defense for it, the heat it's too intense for it. What good would common sense for it do? Because it's witchcraft, wicked witchcraft. And although I know it's strictly taboo, when you arouse the need in me, this heart says yes indeed in me. Proceed with what you are leading me to. It is such an ancient pitch, but one that I'd never switch. Cause babe, there's no nicer witch than you. Because it's witchcraft, that crazy kooky witchcraft. And although I know it's strictly taboo, it's my new dentures. When you arouse the need in me, this heart says yes indeed in me. Proceed with what you are leading me to. It is such an ancient pitch, but one that I never switch. Cause babe, there's no nicer witch than you. Oh, you know it's true, you wicked little witch, you. There it is. That was fun. Took a sip of my water, and it tried to murder me during the song. Which begs to teach us the lesson. Maybe just don't drink water.
Never drink water.
That's right. See what happens there.
It's going to kill you.
A little witchcraft coming your way. And as always on the show, towards the end of the show, we have a lovely saloon song, and tonight is no exception. Sang it at Clanky Robots' fantastic birthday party over the weekend. And it reminded me how fantastic this tune is. So I figured I'd do it on the show. One of my favorites from David Bowie. A little Life on Mars.
It's a god-awful small affair to the girl with the mousy hair, but her mommy is yelling no, and her daddy has told her to go. But her friend is nowhere to be seen as she walks through her sunken dreams to the seat with the clearest view, and she's hooked to the silver screen. But the film is a saddening bore as she's lived it 10 times or more. It's about to be lived again as they ask her to focus on sailors fighting in the dance hall. Oh man, look at them cavemen go. Ain't this the freakiest show? Take a look at the lawman beating up the wrong guy. Oh man, wonder if they'll ever know. They're in the best-selling show. Is there life on Mars. It's on America's tortured brow, Mickey Mouse has grown up a cow, and the workers have struck for fame, 'cause Lenin's on sale again. See the mice in their million hordes, from Ibiza to Norfolk Broads, Rule Britannia's out of bounds. To my mother, my dog, and clowns. But this film is a saddening bore, 'cause she's lived it 10 times or more. It's about to be lived again as they ask her to focus on sailors fighting in the dance hall. Oh man, look at them cavemen go. Ain't this the freakiest show? Take a look at the lawman beating up the wrong guy. Oh man, I wonder if he'll ever know. He's in the best-selling show. Is there life on Mars? Dance hall. Oh man, look at them cavemen go. Ain't this the freakiest show? Take a look at the lawman beating up the wrong guy. Oh man, I wonder if he'll ever know. He's in the best-selling show. Is there life on Mars?
David Bowie coming your way for the saloon song of the night.
I love that one.
That's another fantastic one that does not get done enough on the show.
It's so good.
It's very, very good.
Am I unmuted?
You are unmuted.
Okay, cool.
And in fact, it's time for you to sing.
Chow, 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 chow.
Oh, yes, it is. Those, oh, look at a little stank on that. There you go. A lovely, lovely, those dulcet tunes from Justasmic. Of course, Signal, last call here in the lounge. But of course, we aren't going to leave you on that downward saloon song note. No, no, no. We're leaving you with a fantastic tune tonight about my favorite town. The song is about Chicago, but we've changed it to my adopted hometown, the town we live in, the town we love, full of fantastic people, Anaheim. Gonna end it with a little tune about my kind of town. Now this can only happen to a guy like me, and only happen in a town like this. So may I say to each of you most gratefully, as I blow each one of you a kiss, this is my kind of town, Anaheim is. It's my kind of town, Anaheim is. Why, I just brim like a clown. It's my kind of town. Oh, it's my kind of town, Anaheim is. My kind of town, Anaheim is. It's why I brim like a clown twice. It's my kind of town. Ha! Come on. It is my kind of town, Anaheim is. It's my kind of town, Anaheim is. It's my kind of razzmatazz, and it has, it's got all of that jazz. And each time calling me home, Anaheim is. It's that packing district, Anaheim is. It's that Cookie Mouse house, Anaheim is. It's one town that it never gonna let you down. It's my coming your way for the end of the show this evening. Oh my goodness. I guess since I forgot the lyrics twice, I don't have any leeway next week's show. So, there we go. That's true.
Nobody would have even remembered.
That's fair. Again, as always, you cats, have a fantastic, fantastic week. I thank you for joining us here in the lounge. I hope it provided a fun bit of escape and entertainment on your fine Tuesday evening. So Hope to see you next Tuesday. Hope to see you Sunday at 616 if you're in the area. Come on by, 6 p.m. And if I don't see you, well, I'll see you when I see you, so you can't stay safe out there. Don't be racist. Don't let any idiot around you be racist. You don't have to say don't drink bleach anymore, because nobody does that anymore. No one does that anymore. Again, you cats have a fantastic, fantastic week.
Don't get the shit disease.
That's right, apparently that's going around. Don't get that.
Wash your hands.
Wash your hands. And
wash your hands, don't get the shit disease.
That's just a sign off every week now.
It's important. It can fight them antibiotics.
That's right. You cats have a fantastic, fantastic week. You all deserve it. Are you ready to hit that end curtain button? You got that? There it is. Bye-bye, everyone.